Hey guys, Max Fu here, and I'm not even looking at the camera. Guys, Max Fu here, and I got something interesting for you guys. Like I promised you guys in my last tutorial of trying to make a triangle, I promised you guys I would do a video on properties, and I was going to go to sleep. As you notice, I have the exact same background, clothes, and everything, but I promised you guys I would do properties. So, shall we get started? If you go to your panel, your properties panel, depending on where you have it at, anywhere on your Photoshop screen, if you go there, you'll notice you have a photo, like a normal size photo like this. You have a W, an H, a Y, and a Z. The Z and the Y is the, like, if you remember math class from like high school, you remember the X axle and the Y axle. Yeah, those things is really helpful when you're editing. So when your teacher told you that math matters, they wasn't wrong. So the X and the Y, those different things, is just, imagine this is a graph and this is an axle. The different pixels is that individual, you know, squares in the graph. And the X and the Y is the different things, obviously. And W is for width, and H and obviously for height. So for this photo, you can have different, different units. I'm probably gonna edit that out. This thing, I have it on inches. I usually use pixels, but it was already on inches before I started creating it when I was preparing it. So I'm gonna keep it like that. So if you want it to be a equal height, so let's say you want the width and the height to be equal, just make the width, you can edit it to make it 1 point. I'm gonna use this side. If you can make it 1.2, but wait, you noticed something, it's not equal anymore. It actually grew in height and width, even though you only changed the width. It is going to be proportional all the way through. So the whole photo is going to be proportional. It's not going to change. It's not going to keep the same heights when you change the width. Example, let's say the width was 2 and the height is... No, let's say the width was 1 and the height was 2. And I changed the width to 2, the height is now going to be 4. And now let's say I change the width from 2 to 6. Now the height isn't 4 anymore, it's 12. So if I want to change that, like I am right now for this particular tutorial, you want to change and click on this little link. Thank you. Click on this little link button. Now you can actually change it. So let's say I want to change the width to match the height, which is annoyingly 1.01. We can change that to make it, to not make it not proportional, to make it equal. That is one way to look at properties. Another way you can look at properties is, I have a shape here. The same rules and stuff from the photo works with the shape, but there's a few different things. So we still have our height and our width, our X axle and our Y axle. You can use the properties to make your stroke. And if you don't know what a stroke is, it's not what you think. Get your mind out the gutter. A stroke is basically like a border. So a border and a stroke is literally the exact same thing. So let's say I want to change the color to red. I can change the stroke. If you want to change the actual color to red, that's how you do it. Now let's say I want to change the stroke to black. Don't know if you can see it, but there is a black stroke around the shape. Change this to 25.00 35, just 25 in general. And let's say we're going to change this to a dot. So So this now is like the stroke is like the little dots, the dots that you use to like cut paper with. So if you guys remember from like kindergarten, when you had like the little cut it post-it thingies, like when you had to like color in papers and stuff, those were like the cut it dots. These are dotted lines. These are dashed lines. Okay, so dotted lines is these. Those are actual physical dotted lines. These, what I call the dotted lines, those are actual dashes. If you want to change these, you can use the properties menu. I'm pretty sure you can't change the stroke options, like the physical, like between the dash, dotted, and the straights. I'm pretty sure you can't change between those with the blending option. You can change the different stroke sizes using properties. Now that we got that out of the way, you can also use all these different options, and it's a lot of different options. I usually don't use these, so I have no idea what these are, but these are the kerners of the shape. So let's say I wanted to have a rounded kerner. Let's say I wanted to have, let's say, 25 px for each kerner. Now, each kerner is 25 xp. Let's say I wanted to make the top kerners 25 and the bottom ones 45. Let's say I wanted to do that. Now, it's not 25, it's 35, but wait. It's 35 all around. I only wanted it on the bottom. So let's do Command C or Control C, depending on what system you're on, and click, just like we did with the other one with the pictures, you have to click the link button. So like now you can do the 35 and the 45. Now, as you see, the bottom corners is more rounded than the tops. And you can also use this little menu up here, and it's not menu, this little user input slot to physically manually change it rather than go from each one to each one to each one to change it. So that is the video. You can also have these to like change different things. It's pretty interesting. To see what you can play with and all that type of stuff. So that is going to be, like you saw, it was pretty interesting over there, pretty freaky. So that is going to be the video, you guys. I bet you guys did not know that clouds can be up to 1 million pounds.